Hi, I'm Adam.
And I'm Guy.
And we are Bounder and Cad, musical comedy duo, and tonight, your Valentines. For this Valentine's Day, and indeed this Valentine's night. Are you feeling suitably sexy, Guy?
Yep.
Good. If anyone out there isn't feeling suitably sexy yet, why not hit pause, slip on your favourite t-shirt, and listen again to our radio special, Funny Valentine, on BBC Sounds.
Why?
Let me tell you why. Here's what we'll do for you in Funny Valentine, available now on BBC Sounds, all in a satisfying 15 minutes. We'll reflect on what the artist formerly known as Prince has to say about the subjective nature of beauty. We'll talk about negging.
We'll sing some Akon.
And we'll reveal precisely why James Blunt's life is so brilliant as we look at some intriguing love songs.
Broadcast on last night's Comedy Club. It's ready and waiting for you on BBC Sounds.
But if you've heard it all before, let's get back to tonight, where we've got plenty of hot, hot comedy to get your cheeks flushed.
Take it up a semitone, Sammy boy. At 10:30, Newsjack.
At 11, The Consultants. It's from Neil Edmund and Justin Edwards, and it is cerebral sketch comedy.
Then finally, at 11:30, Bleak Expectations, Mark Evans's Dickensian spoof comedy.
And is that all, Guy?
No. Just to drive you wild, we were holding something back.
And that something is Mark Steele.
A good name for a superhero, if ever I heard one.
Certainly a local hero. Our man Mark visits towns across the UK and performs a unique stand-up set specially tailored to the town.
This is Mark Steele's In Town, and this week he's visiting everyone's favourite Welsh market town, administrative centre and holiday resort,
Aberystwyth. And the Man of Steel, Mr. Mark, will be back next week at the same time when he'll be heading to the Forest of...
Dean?
Correct. Guy, would you believe me if I told you that the next programme was written through what's known as crowdsourcing?
Maybe. Tell me a bit more.
Sure. This programme invites the British public to submit one-liners and sketches based around recent news stories. Then the best ones are selected and performed by a revolving cast of comedians.
Power to the people! What a brilliant model.
It is, and the results are hilarious.
Well, who'd have thought? A democratic process that produces hilarious results.
I know. And even more excitingly, it's hosted by Kerry Pritchard-McLean, who we recently saw comparing that comedy night we went to called Suspiciously Cheap Comedy.
So he did. Thanks again for taking me to that.
It was my pleasure. And it was cheap. Right, over to Kerry with Newsjack. And at the same time next week, we will have Alan Partridge in Knowing Me, Knowing You.
Aha!
Yes.
What?
Nothing.
Cool.
Hungry?
Why?
Popcorn?
Salty?
Sweet.
Perfect.
Voila.
Ta.
Good.
Whoever said radio couldn't be interactive? I personally don't know. But what I do know is that we're going to get all interactive now. I'm going to present a series of options for the next programme, and Adam is going to choose.
Cool, let's play.
Okay, option one, The Consultants. Cerebral sketch comedy from 2004, starring Neil Edmund and Justin Edwards.
Yes.
Wait, there are six more options.
Doesn't matter, that's the one I want.
You sure?
Yeah.
Cripes. Gotta admit, I like your style.
I do not regret my choice. And at the same time next week, it'll be Newsjack, half an hour later than you're used to having it.
Aha!
So, Valentine's Day is almost over.
It's been nice sharing the last couple of hours with you, listeners.
Though we might have hoped you guys would have something more exciting to do between 10 p.m. and midnight on Valentine's night.
Easy on the judgment, Judge Dredd. There's no shame in preferring to spend a quiet night in by yourself with the old wireless. That's what I do most evenings, usually from about 8 p.m.
Really?
Yes, I've told you before.
You know that I
don't stay out late, don't care to go. I'm home about 8, just me and my radio.
Well, cool.
Good. So our final programme tonight is Mark Evans's Dickensian spoof, Bleak Expectations.
And this week, Pip and Charles Dickens engage in a novel writing showdown to work out who's the better writer.
Place your bets.
And Bleak Expectations will be back at the same time next week when a new and terrible danger threatens Britain.
But now, the end is near.
We must bid goodnight to all you Valentines out there.
And thank you for having us these last four nights as your companions here at the Comedy Club.
But we wouldn't wish to leave you without a song. A love song, albeit of the more bittersweet kind.
The breakup song. This one's sung by two heartbroken lads called Michel Barnier and Jean-Claude Juncker.
My friends, as once you were, it was a dream so European.
But fine, as you prefer, take back control, so North Korean. It's why de Gaulle said no. Those roast beef Brits will only vex it.
Then bon, Dave Cameron brought us le Brexit.
Like clubs, we charge a fee.
But negatives, they come with pluses.
You gain that back times three.
So go and stick that on your buses.
But fine, go get your coat. But first, the bill.
The waiter checks it. It's for 39 billion.
That's for le Brexit.
No more free trade. So burn your ships.
You keep your bovril, your fish and chips.
No more champagne, you Saxon swine.
No more butter mountains, no lakes of wine.
Go build your wall.
Make Britain small.
Pourquoi le Brexit?
And migrants. Oh, the fear. Ooh. Will you believe those rabble rousers?
Net gains. $2 billion each year.
Free movement's good.
Observe my trousers.
Praise Merkel, Europe's light. She isn't trying to annex it.
No. This kraut will buy you out. So was this Brexit. Farewell then, old friend. Have your divorce.
Bend your bananas. Eat your pet horse.
Go make your hoovers like typhoons.
And let your kids blow up balloons.
You want it hard.
Alors, en garde.
Show us your Brexit.
You may still ask, what does it mean?
Can't conjugate or circumflex it.
We'll see.
Bof, c'est la vie.
Brexit means Brexit.